What is happening? Look at this. Really weird.
Ahoy everyone, I'm Econael and today I want to show you something very interesting that I just stumbled upon. It's called Blinky and it is a proof of concept about peripheral vision in games. Now in the past you may have tried setting your FOV to higher than 120 degrees and it ends up looking distorted like in the image on the left. But if other kinds of projections are used, for example like the Panini projection, you can actually play with 170 degrees without any problem, and in fact you can actually play with 360 degrees without it looking crazy. And we'll take a look at that in the demo. Alright, so here we are in the demo and I'm gonna show you how it actually works. I think this is the right hotkey, yeah. So it's rendering the whole globe around you into this cube, and then it projects this cube into, for example, this is the Panini projection, and then there is this. The Panini projection is 170 degrees, then there's this stereographic projection, which is very similar to the Panini. The difference is that the lines are warped here, whereas in the Panini the lines of the central cubes, at least the vertical lines, are pretty straight. Then there is the hammer projection, which looks like that. Also the winkle triple projection, which takes a while to build up. But I've looked at all of them and I think this is the one I'm gonna show you a little bit of gameplay with. Now this is Quake 1, pretty old game, but it's fun nonetheless. And then there is also the Fisheye projection, not very useful, but just for demonstration purposes. As well as the Mercator projection, which you may know from maps. Here you see that the bottom and the top of the screen are very heavily distorted, which explains what happens when you look down or up. And we will not be playing with that because it looks pretty hard to aim with it just when you move the mouse around. Then there is also the... I think this was it, yeah, and also the cube. So we will be playing with the... where is it? Not Mercator, the Winkle triple projection. Let's wait till it builds up. Because I found it the most useful in my tests. And well, the big deal is that you can see everything. You can look around you, nothing can scare you. I mean, obviously the game isn't made for that, but let's try it anyway. So the game will be... I have to set my mouse sensitivity a bit higher. The game is obviously not made for vision like this, and if it were, the level design would probably be a bit different. But as you can see, I can see everything. I can see behind me. Nothing can scare me now. Come at me. Oh, a dog. Now, aiming is a bit harder with projections like these. Thankfully, aiming in Quake 1 isn't that hard. You don't have to aim too well. But I guess if you don't overdo it, then just use the Panini projection. I can imagine getting used to the Panini projection. We'll play with that maybe later on. For now, I want to show 360 view in gaming. And it does work. Oh no, what happened? Doesn't matter, I can see everywhere. Oh, there's an enemy. Shoot him. I also find it kind of a little bit easier to orient myself when I can always see everything around me, because can I trigger something if I shoot there? Oh, maybe not. Because there's always some part of the level that you've seen before that's always in a field of view. And no matter how quickly you spin around, you never lose a point of reference. So I actually find it pretty easy to orient myself with this kind of projection where I see everything. I think I got a power up. And this was the end of level 1. Alright. Now when I showed this to my mom, she said it was really nauseating. But I guess, as a gamer, it's kind of easy to get used to stuff like that. And if they start using this kind of projection in games, I'm sure that people can adapt pretty quickly. Oh, There seems to be a door here. See? I maybe would have missed the door if I didn't have 360 degree vision. I guess platforming would be a bit difficult with this though. Sweet. I wish I could play Quake 3 Arena with this. Would be quite a different experience. So the demo is available. You can download it. I think there's a Windows and a Linux version available, and you could just try it out for yourself. Oh, that's key. And oop. I'll be switching to the Panini view, which I also like a lot. It's only 170 degrees, which is also very unusual for a game. But I think it works really well on a widescreen monitor, if you ask me. Oh, this is a sequence where I'm gonna try the mech contour, which is a bit funky. But I think this is a sequence, if I remember correctly, where it's quite nice to be able to look behind you. Because this thing starts jumping out at you. Oh. If there's not much verticality, then... Well, I guess the aiming works, even if you would have to aim up, because the middle of the screen is never never quite as distorted, but... It just seems funky if you look up and then turn. What is happening? Look at this. Really weird. But we're gonna finish the level, finish this presentation. If you're interested in it, pick up the demo, try it for yourself. I think this is certainly very, very interesting. If not for playing, then at least for spectating games. And I hope that game engines start implementing this. So thank you very much for your attention and goodbye.